Hello, I'm Nicholas Hoare for Vermont PBS. Schlumberger is extremely well known as one of the largest oil services companies in the world. It's responsible for roughly 70% of such services and is headquartered in Houston, Texas. Houston, Texas in the Second World War was not what Houston, Texas is today. And one of the leading proponents of that remarkable city was a couple called Jean and Dominique de Menil. Dominique, a Schlumberger herself, came with her husband to live in Houston in the Second World War and galvanized the cultural aspect of that city in no time flat. Years later, brand new, this remarkable book came out devoted solely to the two of them and their creation, the de Menil Collection in Houston, which is an extremely handsome museum and which I'll go into in a moment. The title of the book is Double Vision, The Unerring Eye of Dominique and John de Menil. And the author, who is William Middleton, has written an artistic classic. This is 700 pages of the richest possible art history going. It's one of the best I've handled in a long, long time, and it's riveting, both from the French Connection and from the States. There's Caracas, there's Paris, there's London, there's Houston, there's New York. It's set all over the world, and it is absolutely fascinating from start to finish. The museum they put together, this remarkable couple, is based in Houston, as I say, and looks like this. It was designed by a very well-known Italian architect called Renzo Piano, and it opened in 1987. And that brings me to the passage I'm going to read, which will give you a flavor of what this book is about. And this is just one page. The sweltering summer of June the 4th, 1987, was the official opening of the Menil Collection, and the 79-year-old Dominique de Menil stood in front of her new museum. Her adopted hometown of Houston, Texas, had seen oil prices plummet in the mid-80s as the rest of the country recovered from recession. With 70% of the city's wealth tied to the oil industry, Houston construction stagnated, unemployment soared, banks failed. The inauguration of the Menil Collection at this particular moment only further underscored the staggering artistic, civic and philanthropic contributions that Dominique and her husband John de Menil had been making to the city for nearly half a century. Designed by Renzo Piano, the building was a bold, graceful two-story structure of white steel, clear glass and gray cypress siding, with an interior of pristine white walls, glistening black wood floors and floor-to-ceiling windows opening onto lush tropical gardens. Inside, however, were more than 10,000 works of art, one of the largest and most important private collections of art ever assembled in the 20th century. Paleolithic bone carvings, Cycladic idols, Byzantine relics, African totems, oceanic effigies, as well as modernist masterpieces from Cézanne, Picasso, Braque, Magritte, Ernst, Calder, Rothko, Rauschenberg, Warhol, and Johns. Need I say more? The book is extraordinary. It is not only an absolutely riveting read, it is also surprisingly easy to read. You would think that a 700-page magnum opus would be an absolutely deadly experience. Not at all. You breeze through it. I cannot commend this book more. It is immensely gossipy. It is absolutely fascinating. And for those of, shall we say, a societal bent, cannot be bettered. I commend it highly. And on that artistic note, good evening.